But she has beaten players Lily's level.
Well, and in fact, she just did.
Yeah. By rating, yes.
Yes, by rating. And two lovely women, too. Lily a bit older, at 20. Angela, a couple years, just graduating from high school this year.
Although they live in the Bay Area and they're teammates on the national team, they don't practice together, so that might be a slight advantage to Angela because Lily doesn't get a chance to play with choppers all that often.
True enough, although in the World Championships, Lily, a couple years ago, showed her stuff against Chop.
She pushed her down, yep.
Beating, I think it was, what was it, Victoria Pavlovich, if I remember?
Yes.
Yeah.
Credit Coach Doru for that. That great tactics in that match. If you watch, he basically just kept, she kept pushing to Victoria's long pips. And funny enough, for a player that level, had no answer for something so sort of basic.
Well, and so having beaten a world top 20 chopper, on, you would think that style is really an advantage.
Although, in the World Team Championships, when they played Korea, she played a chopper, and that was a mess.
Yeah, no, that's true, that's true. So, well, and I think the interesting variable here, as we saw in the last match, is clearly what's Angela going to do? I mean, Angela's developing more capabilities.
Right.
Angela's developing, you know, lots of confidence. Angela knows she can beat a player of this level. Angela is probably tired of losing so many matches to Lily. So
there's always a time. There's always a time where you're going to get to your first win.
Yeah. And the other thing I think we've seen too, you know, when one player has such a record against another, particularly when the other player is up and coming, is a little younger, a little lower level, at some point, if that first win occurs, it can really break the ice, it can really change the dynamics. So there may be a little more at stake here than just this state championship for, you know, Lily is the top of the game, top of the women, Olympian again. She's not going to want to let Angela in.
Both players will have coaches since they're not from the same club. Lily will be coached by Massimo Constantini. Angela will be coached by her mother, Kathleen Chen.
And right away, it's a completely different looking match than the last one. Lily and Zawin Ting are not that similar as players. And I know that Lily has been coached quite a lot about playing against Chop. She does have the extra weapon, too, in a backhand loop. That is one of her strong shots. There's a lot on it. Both players ready to play. No hesitation on either part. Forced error from Lily there. Not a good decision. Lily Lily a little surprised on two consecutive points by the strength of Angela's spin. Another thing for players out there to watch is when Angela is chopping or pushing that way, she really does dig into it and make a shot out of each push. It's not just getting the ball back. It's really digging in. Does not want to give her opponent the breather of an easy opening. Well, the serve that Angela relied on in the last match paid off for her there. Back to 5-all after Lily ran up 4-1. Lily gives a definite sense of purpose when she comes to the table. Her serving position is very well practiced. She's not making anything up. Lily very well trained and skilled. She knows what her game is. That's an advantage for a player. She doesn't have to improvise. She knows what she wants to do. Beautiful. Two lovely drop shots and an outright backhand winner.
That's the difference we're seeing too, Carl. Lily is playing some drop shots, and we didn't see that at all from Zhang Wenting. It's a good play against a chopper to play a drop shot. You make them come all the way in, because they have to get a long way back to be able to play defense.
Well, exactly, Corey. And it's also just a nice way to stay in the point. You need a way. A safe thing you can play against the chopper that doesn't put you at any risk. Beautiful pick loop from Angela that way, and she picked a good spot again. All right, still it's 6-9. Lily recreated that separation she had at the start of the game. Lily's got 4 game points here. And that's it for the first game. Lily Zhang, top seed, trying to take what would be her first California State Women's Championship. She handles Angela Guan pretty well. A little bit of a rough patch. She went up 4-1. Angela tied it at 5-all. But then Lily went up 7-5 and didn't look back.
It's just a tough matchup for Angela playing Lily. Angela's game is really straight. There's nothing really kind of funky that she can throw in at Lily. Her attack's not strong enough to go through Lily. And Lily can kind of spin all day. She's got power to go through her. She makes really good placements. Just a nightmare style matchup for her. For Angela.
Well, and also I think the Lily has a tremendous maturity as a player.
Yeah, she's not going to go wild and all of a sudden lose 5 points in a row for no reason or something like that some of the less mature players have the ability to do.
Yeah. Angela did fool her a little bit in the towards the middle part of that first game with some heavy underspin that Lily didn't quite expect. But she made the adjustment at least in the first game. Yeah, that's a difficult thing for a defender. You have to know whether your basic approach to the game is going to get you traction or not.
And that's the power. And she didn't just whack it to a careless spot. It went right into that middle forehand where Angelo couldn't get a racket on it.
Beautiful opening loop, and that smash actually had a fair amount of topspin on it, too.
Yeah.
Textbook. Okay, there we go. Angela understands, I guess, that anything loose she has to go right at. She did it again. There's the first adjustment in the match. Angela's taking the attack immediately on the first opportunity.
She's clearly trying to throw like a little monkey wrench into the plan of Lily Zhang.
Well, and then to score some points too. I mean, she wasn't getting anywhere otherwise. It's a dual benefit. Oh, that is so beautiful from Lily. Watch what, one thing I want everyone to watch on TV, if you can see it, not only does she crouch down with her and drive her strong legs through those loops, she lets her backswing go farther back than a lot of people will. So she's getting some velocity on the swing and power from the legs both. Keep an eye on her when she takes that loop against the heavier balls. Some players will do one or the other. They'll drive their legs or they'll take a big backswing on that ball. She's doing both, and I don't think she's missed a loop like that in the net yet.
No, I haven't seen her miss that one yet.
And as we saw in the prior match, she whiffed one, but Angela's balls are heavy. Well, okay. A little mental error from Lily that time. Just like last game, a quick lead for Lily and Angela comes back. Oh, those are two beautiful forehands. Both off heavy balls. Beautiful backhand that time. Notice how Lily crouches to receive serve also. Beautiful flurry from Angela. Not just an attack, but a second follow-up ball. Legs wide, down low. It's a full professional stance. Funny thing about a playing a capable defender, you do all sorts of good things and the ball flies around a little bit and it's still tied.
I know, an awful lot of work for a tie score.
Yeah. Of course, Angela got a little lucky with the edge there, but she still had made a good return. Yeah, okay, a little misfire there. Well, he wasn't quite in position for that ball and swung out sideways at it. You could see Angela wondering what she should do in that rally. She ended up just pushing. But she hasn't shown that aggressiveness of late. There we go. That was a nice serve. Little surprise, long and spinny. She's flipping very comfortably. Oh, Lily let her off the hook there. Angela had a ball to hit and backed away. Gave Lily the opening, but suddenly, Angela is within striking distance of evening the match.
Shocker, she's on our side call.
Yeah. Lily looking around a little bit. Did not like that miss, but Angela forced it with a nice wide push. Oh, there again. Lily in perfect position and got a full swing at that one. Angela taking the partial timeout here with the towel. And a winner. Angela Guan trying to continue her improbable march through this draw. I mean, not so improbable. She's the third seed. But a definite underdog in both the semifinal and this match. And she's tied it up with Olympian Lily Zhang.
Angela really takes a kind of a, just a workmanlike approach to everything. She doesn't get too high and doesn't get too low. She just kind of grinds it out one point at a time. And she really does a good job of forcing her opponent to win 11 points. She's not going to give you anything. In order to beat Angela in one game, you have to score 11 points. And that's sometimes the difficult thing is when you don't have, when your opponent's not helping you out, not making any mistakes, it makes it more difficult.
Well, true enough, and she's also, as we've said in the last year, she's spiced up her game a little bit, and so she's taking a couple of them too with her offense. And of course, as we've said before, that's a vital part of a defensive player's game. The way I've described it to Angela before in giving her advice is that she needed to be more annoying.
Yeah. Yeah, and you're right about that. I mean, she needs to find a way to kind of put a monkey wrench into the whole problem, right? So that everything isn't so clean all the time, right? Sometimes you play with a little gooey side spin, she's developed a really nice hit with her long pips.
See, now that's Lily's point, the way that one developed. Angela's got to change that up somehow.
Angela's way too far back to try to counter loop that ball.
Yeah. Well, she had to try something, but that's the line that Angela does not want to play and that Lily wants to play all day. See, that's more to Angela's favor that time. She emphasized the backhand, went hard at it.
Yeah, she twiddled that time and used her smooth for the push on the backhand.
Uncharacteristic mental error from Lily there. That was a fairly tough ball and not one you could flat kill at that angle. Interesting to me is that Lily is using her serve primarily for positioning, which is again what you should do against a defender. It's not so much what the spin's on it. She's trying to conceal where it's going and force Angela to reach a little bit so she can open. Even up in the early going here in game three. Finals, the women's singles in the California State Championship.
That's such a nice hit with the long pips. That ball is so kind of gooey and nasty because the stroke is, it looks like it's a topspin ball, but it's completely dead.
That's the annoying ball.
Yeah.
And the great thing about it is if you pull it off, it doesn't have to be a particularly risky shot for the defender.
Yeah, Andrew's playing really well this game too. It's 3-3, but two of Lily's points is she's gotten an edge ball and a net ball.
Yep.
So Angela's still giving her nothing and just playing really solid.
Yep. Yeah. Definite turnaround from the first game. Oh, little lucky there. Lily had a nice run going and then just threw in that net ball. You know, it's a funny thing. That time Angela thought she saw an opening. She came cross court with a fairly heavy side spin, underspin push, and went right into Lily's wheelhouse. I guess the player of Lily's quality, there are some things you probably just shouldn't do. And playing that angle.
Yeah, is one of them.
Is one of them in this match. See, there it is again. There's no reason for Angela to give her that angle and to play that cross-court ball right out to the forehand. It's exactly what Lily wants. She's very comfortable moving right and picking it right up. And it gets her right into the rally that favors her. See? Yep.
Is what should be happening is Angela should be doing a better job of playing the long pips on the ball as much as possible. Because the long pips kind of slows everything down a little bit. The more energy she gives Lily, kind of, the more power Lily gives her back.
Beautiful backhand there. We haven't seen as many of those as we do in a normal match from Lily, but when she gets a swing at it, it's a full-throated shot. You know, she's swinging from her feet on that one. Well, suddenly it's 8-4. There's no future in that for Angela. Lily is not going to topspin point like that. Five in a row for Lily. All right. Broke the string. But Lily's got two service points here. Angela Guan still in this. Two serves to tie it up.
Okay, open doubles starting. Anita Rahama, Anastasia Wang.
Three game points for Lily Zhang to take a 2-1 lead in this women's singles final, and she does. Only needs one of them. Well, interesting game there, Corey. But in the end, Lily sees her way clear.
Lily kind of back in the driver's seat, started making her attacks kind of a little bit stronger. And part of that was probably the poor technical decision by Angela to be serving out to Lily's forehand. Not a great decision. It opens up Angela's forehand, and Lily's forehand against Angela's forehand is not how Angela wants to play the match at all. So we'll see if Angela makes that adjustment.
Yeah, no, it's it kind of seems as if Lily has a big advantage looping her forehand back down at Angela's forehand and then taking the middle of the table when she gets it going. The rest of the time, Angela's competitive.
Yeah, Angela's got to keep finding a way to make the point a little bit longer and a little bit longer. Get her attacks in sometimes, but she can't try to attack when the ball's not there. Sometimes she loses patience and forces the attack, but
Well, we'll see. She's quite a trooper, and stayed in really well before, and I think she'll stay in here. I don't see either player, you know, getting issues of commitment and fighting spirit. I think it's a tactical match at this point. You know, Angela played a great point there, and it wasn't enough.
Yeah.
It's just not the line she can play. That's much better. Much better for Angela. The annoying pick hit. One of the things that Lily does that I want to call out again against defensive players, and not enough players do this either. Beautiful again from Angela. We saw it in the earlier point. When the defender attacks, she treats it as if she's playing an offensive player and just goes right back at it without hesitation. And there she did it again. Too many players, when the defender attacks, they're just content to kind of bring it back, to kind of control it. But Lily sees it as an opportunity and goes right after the ball. So that's why Angela's got to be a little careful with what she's doing. Can't loop or attack into that forehand unless it's really good. And maybe not even then. Well, lucky break there, but it was a beautiful chop all the same.
Yeah. Lily's attack was right on the back of the white lines. Angela found a way to get it back.
Short.
Yeah.
Yep. Lily's kind of point. I don't know. To me, Corey, it just comes down to, can Lily play, you know, if she can play four or five of her kind of points each game, it's probably enough.
Yeah.
Because she's not, you know, Angela can win points. She does get some errors. She has a little bit of attack, but.
But her attack's not enough to win her a game. She's going to need some help from Lily.
Yeah.
In order for Angela to win.
Well, she's going to need to somehow stop this from happening. Yeah. No, that was a. Angela's a little lost here at the moment, tactically. Lucky shot at the end there, but boy, Angela did everything she could in that point, and it still was not enough. Beautiful rally, mixed in the attack, made some lovely retrieves, didn't faze Lily one bit. Lily was ready for that backhand that time. The problem with that little flip is that if the other player anticipates it, it's just a fat nothing ball. All right. Nice shot from Angela. She needs a few more. Oh, good break there. Lily misfired on one that she usually makes. We're kind of back to holding your serve, and Angela just did it. Women's singles final here in the California State Championships, best of seven. Lily Zhang trying to extend her 2-1 lead. Smart play from Angela, right back at the backhand. Angela's got three in a row. She needs a few more. Wow. Did she tire Lily out on that point? I don't quite know what happened there. But
she was so close to the net. I don't know how she missed it.
Yeah. A little extra topspin, I think, on Angela's ball that she didn't see. In any case, it's four in a row. What were we saying before, Corey, about you do all this work against a chopper and suddenly, you know, what did it buy you?
Yeah, no doubt. Well,
five in a row for Angela Guan.
Angela was the favorite to win this game from the get-go, her being on our side.
I guess that's right.
And she's even...
Well...
She's even kind of doing everything wrong. Still finding a way to keep this game.
Well,
a
lot of scrambling, a lot of heart. She's fighting really hard.
That's true. Tactically, though.
Well, that last point, no. I mean, it was not what the doctor ordered at all. Let's see what happens here. Big game. Too tough. Lily made a really good angled opening loop, and that was about all she wrote on that point. Angela's going to have a tough time here on this return, trying to keep Lily from finding her forehand. Oh, a little bit lucky.
Angela got her back the previous 2 points. Lily got a net each point.
Fair enough.
A little bit of payback there.
Well, and again, it was a good return. It was short.
If I'm in Angela's corner, I call a timeout and tell her under no circumstance to do that long tomahawk serve to the forehand. Give her some sort of plan.
Well, she.
Yeah, this is better.
Yeah. Okay.
But if I was in the corner and I saw her line up for that tomahawk serve, I'd call a timeout right away. Just the long serve to the forehand.
It was a surprise, but it was a surprise to her strength.
Yeah.
And it wasn't enough of a surprise.
She's serving long to her forehand all the time. I don't think Lily was too shocked.
Oh, bad break there. See, that's the tough thing. Angela, it was a surprise to Lily. Now, if Angela was prepared to follow with a reloop, that would have been an ideal situation because she did force Lily to slow down, roll it up a little bit, which she did. But since Angela wasn't prepared to come in behind it with a big forehand, all it did was put her at a disadvantage.
Yeah.
It's one of those tough things when you're playing a strong player. Do you want to give them the chance to miss their best shot?
No, you don't want them to take their best shot.
Well, that's what I think, too. That's where I come from. You know, I don't want to give my opponent the swing that can beat me.
Yeah, and her forehand.
Even if I think they might miss, you know.
And her forehand's been beating the crap out of you all day. You don't want Lily to be taking forehands without having to work for it at least. Make her work for it. You know, if she earns.
Take it out of the backhand corner or something,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
You just do not want to make her give her that comfortable opening. Well, that was a pretty important game there. At 9-all, it could have been tied or it could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 3-1. And this time, Angela's got the big hole to dig out of. And she starts off with trying an immediate attack.
Oh.
And here comes the timeout. Lily with a 3-love lead. You know, that's a tough thing for Angela coming off that last game. I think she came back and nearly won it just playing her game.
Yeah.
And yet you come out 1-3 down now.
Yeah.
And the temptation is to feel like, well, do I need to do something different? Do I need to try something? And you can see in the start of that game there, she made a couple, tried a few flurries, and they just weren't, they weren't the good idea. And suddenly.
And the other thing too is now that Lily's a little bit looser, she has the wind at her back, so to speak, with a 3-1 lead.
Well, she does, although it's not as if she's been tight to this point either. I mean, she's, you know, I think.
But sometimes that's what the defenders need, is they need that scoreboard pressure to make the shots be just sometimes just a little bit unsure.
No, it's right. That's right. And certainly there's nothing, you know, as tight as that last game was, you know, one missed swinger here or there is going to make a big difference. Okay. Real critical point of the match right here. Does Lily run away with it, or does Angela dig back in? That was a little optimistic on Lily's part. That's the other problem that can happen when you start to get...
You get too loose.
Get a little too loose and just decide now's the time to go for something and put this out.
That's the serve. That's the serve Angela should be doing. Serve long final. Serve into the backhand corner to create the backhand-to-backhand dynamic where you can use the long pips or you can step around and use your forehand.
Yeah. Boy, Angela, when she's attacked forehand to forehand, she's just gotten nowhere. And some of them are pretty good attacks.
Yeah. It's almost like the more she does it, she gets further and further behind in the point. She doesn't know it.
Well, it's what we were saying earlier in the day. You take your best shot, and you think, I can just hit it anywhere, because it's my best shot. Well,
yeah.
That point's all Lily.
But the most important factor in the attack is the location. At the higher levels, it's so much more important than how fast or how much spin. The location has to be correct.
That was good location. And it didn't have to be that forceful.
Staying out of that forehand to forehand cross court.
Yeah, she's crept into it just a little, but then got out of it.
She's hit forehands way harder than that, but Lily just takes it and rips it right back at her.
Yes.
But that time the direction.
Yeah. Lily got a lot of spin on that backhand just now, too. Mm-hmm. Angela's got to do something here, or she's going to have the runner-up trophy. Oh. Valiant effort at playing a losing tactic. And really pretty finish by Lily. Well, we started this way last game. It was 7-3, remember? And Angela crept back. Difficult play there. Sometimes you work so hard to put a fine edge on a shot you really shouldn't be trying. Even if she succeeds in that push, it's still cross court to the forehand again.
Still a better point that time though.
Yeah, but it's
ended with an unforced error, but
yeah.
The setup of the point was much better. One thing, though, Angela's, you know, they have a good system with her and her mother, and they work well together. They video the matches. They're going to go home and watch this match, and they're going to learn a lot from it. Mm-hmm. They're going to learn that you can't play that forehand to forehand dynamic, and they'll come back with a better game plan next time.
Nice conclusion by Lily Zhang, the California State Women's Champion. And not a surprise, I suppose, for the top seed and our two-time Olympian to take the title from a terrific competitor and fellow team member, Angela Guan. Congratulations to both players.
Absolutely. And when we come back, we will have the number one seed, Bob Chen, against U.S. Open champion, Jinshin Wang.
Open men's single semifinals on table number two, Bob Chen, Wang Jinshin Wang.